120 million years ago, a giant meat-eating dinosaur as big as Tyrannosaurus Rex plodded through a shallow bog on a searing hot day somewhere in what today would be called Southwest Arkansas. As it strode across the scorching landscape, it left tracks behind in the muddy ground. Over the course of time, dinosaurs became extinct. Limestone buried the tracks, hills surged, forests grew. Humans arrived in the Americas and inhabited the landscape that would become Arkansas. Finally, the tracks became exposed to daylight once more. And today, University of Arkansas scientists are studying the tracks to learn more about the creatures that walked the planet so long ago.
There certainly are more than one generation of tracks on this surface. We can actually see some tracks that are eroded and degraded somewhat that are older than other tracks that are here. And so that'll help us get a sense of how often and how frequently dinosaurs were walking around on this thing.
The researchers used many tools to study the site, which contains hundreds of tracks and covers the area of about 2 football fields. Some of the tools were old school, like whisk brooms, hammers and picks, tape measures and notebooks, and plaster and burlap. Other tools were more hip, such as a laser scanner that could create a detailed map of the surface and the prints. Using the laser scanner proved to be a challenge because it needs to be perpendicular to the surface.
We do that using a boom lift that raises the scanner up about 10 meters, 8 to 10 meters above the ground, and then we can scan downward from that into a circular radius.
All these tools, old and new, will allow the researchers to learn more about the dinosaurs who walked through the area.
This particular track type has never before been described in Arkansas, so that's unique. And it's known from other places, Central Texas, southeastern Oklahoma, and even there's some track sites in Maryland. So this kind of really extends the known geographic range of where this particular organism lived. In addition to these tracks, there are quite a variety of other tracks on this particular site, and that gives us a glimpse of what the dinosaur diversity was at the time these tracks were being made.
This is really interesting because we're sort of along the Gulf Coastal Plain here, and you can really get a snapshot into time in this region.
This is also really important to try to help understand like migration and paleogeography, you know, the outline of the coastline and stuff like that back in the Cretaceous.
They also can use the site to learn what the climate was like 120 million years ago.
What's unique about the surface that has these dinosaur tracks on it is that we know for certain that this was a surface that was exposed at the Earth's surface to the atmosphere at the time that these things were walking around because their footprints are in it.
These rocks were deposited during a time that was very warm. It was a global warming period, so it was a greenhouse warming period. And the reason why that's important is we can use the climate during that time in the Cretaceous to help us understand future climates.
The researchers have a lot of work to do before they can fill in the details from the clues left at the site. But even with the work ahead of them, the excitement level remains high.
The one thing I always like to tell people is that tracks are trace fossils. Normally when you think of a fossil, you think of the skeleton of an animal, which is considered a body fossil. And trace fossils are really interesting because they represent the behavior of ancient organisms, and you can get information out of them that you could never get out of a body fossil. A body fossil, when an animal dies, it can be transported out to sea and reburied. But these tracks were formed exactly right here. We know a dinosaur stepped on this exact spot 110 million years ago. That's really cool.